Hello to everybody today. My name is Sister Eleanor. I'm a member of the community, Teo community of Interfaith Franciscans. I'd like to welcome you to Vespers today on this Christmas day. So Merry Christmas to all of you and hope you've had a glorious day or are about to have a glorious day. Right now here, it's in the middle of the day, so we still haven't had Christmas dinner or anything like that. So, we're looking forward to that. So today is the final destination of all of our prayers and all of our introspection of Advent. So I hope God gives you choice blessings on this Christmas day. We have our candle that's lit for peace, and we will say now our peace prayer. When the song of the angels is stilled, when the star in the sky is gone, when the kings and princes are home, when the shepherds are back with their flocks, the work of Christmas begins, to find the lost, to heal the broken, to feed the hungry, to release the prisoner, to rebuild the nations, to bring peace among others, and to make music in the heart. Amen. O God, come to our assistance. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory to our Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus, our teacher, and to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. And now our hymn for today is O Come All Ye Faithful by Nat King Cole. Okay, let us continue now with our Vesper prayer for Christmas Day. We're going to pray as we always do on Sundays and really special holy days, Psalm 110, speaking of the Messiah as King and Priest. The antiphon is, You have been endowed from your birth with princely gifts. In eternal splendor before the dawn of light on earth, I have begotten you. The Lord's revelation to my Master, sit on my right, your foes I will put beneath your feet. The Lord will wield from Zion your scepter of power, rule in the midst of all of your foes. A prince from the day of your birth on the holy mountains, from the womb before the dawn I begot you. The Lord has sworn an oath that he will not change. You are a priest forever, a priest like Melchizedek of old. The master standing at your right hand will shatter kings in the day of his great wrath. He shall drink from the stream by the wayside, and therefore he shall lift up his head. Glory to our Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus, our teacher, and to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. You have been endowed from your birth with princely gifts, in eternal splendor before the dawn of light on earth, I have begotten you. And now, dear ones, let us continue our Christmas Day journey in prayer as we pray Psalm 130. And the main focus of this psalm is a cry from the depths. The antiphon is, "With the Lord is unfailing love, and great is his power to save." Out of the depths I cry to you, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. O let your ears be attentive to the voice of my pleading. If you, O Lord, should mark our guilt, Lord, who would survive? But with you is found forgiveness, and for this we revere you. My soul is waiting for the Lord. I count on his word. My soul is longing for the Lord more than watchmen for daybreak. Let the watchman count on daybreak, and Israel on the Lord. Because with the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption. Israel, indeed, he will redeem from all its iniquity. Glory to our Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus, our teacher, and to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. With the Lord is unfailing love, and great is his power to save. And now, dear ones, let us pray this canticle from Colossians. The antiphon is, "In the beginning, before time began, the Word was God, and today he is born. He is the Savior of the world." Let us give thanks to the Father, Mother God, for having made you worthy to share the lot of the saints in light. He rescued us from the power of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of his beloved Son. Through him we have redemption and the forgiveness of our sins. He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creatures. In him everything in heaven and on earth was created, things both visible and invisible. All were created through him, and all were created for him. He is above all else that is. In him everything continues in being. It is he who is head of the body, he who is the beginning and the firstborn of the dead, so that primacy may be his in everything. It pleased God to make absolute fullness reside in him, and by means of him to reconcile everything in his person, both on earth and in the heavens, making peace through the blood of his cross. Glory to our Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus, our teacher, and to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The antiphon again, "In the beginning, before time began, the Word was God. Today he is born, the Savior of the world." And we thank God for that, the Savior of the world is born today to give us his blessings, redemption, and everything good and holy. Now we have a reading from 1 John. "This is what we proclaim to you, what was from the beginning and what we have heard, what we have seen with our eyes, what we have looked upon and our hands have touched. We speak of the word of life. This life became visible. We have seen and bear witness to it. And we proclaim to you the eternal life that was present to the Father, Mother, God, and became visible to us. What we have seen and heard, we proclaim in turn to you, so that you may share that life with us. The fellowship of ours is with our Father, Mother, God, and with his Son, Jesus Christ." Our response is, "The Word was made man. Alleluia, alleluia. The Word was made man. Alleluia, alleluia. He lived among us. Alleluia, alleluia. Glory to our Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus, our teacher, and to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Alleluia. So it is a wonderful thing to really contemplate the fact that the God of all creation had come down to earth in the form of a baby, in the form of a man, and to honor us, to be one of us, to be a human being like the rest of us. So we thank God for his great gift, the gift of the cosmic Christ, so he could show us how to live, what to do, and how to have mainly fellowship and a relationship with our Father, Mother, God. So now we honor Mary on this special day after she's given birth to the Savior of the world. And we pray the canticle of Mary. So we'll pray the antiphon, and then after that we'll have Luciano Pavarotti singing Ave Maria. The antiphon is, Christ the Lord is born today. Today the Savior has appeared. Earth echoes songs of angel choirs, archangels, joyful praise. Today on earth his friends exult. Glory to God in the highest. Alleluia. That was the beautiful rendition of Ave Maria by Luciano Pavarotti. And we say the canticle antiphon again. Christ the Lord is born today. Today the Savior has appeared. Earth echoes songs of angel choirs, archangels' joyful praise. Today on earth his friends exult. Glory to God in the highest. Alleluia. Now we come on this beautiful Christmas day to pray for ourselves, to pray for our friends and family, and to pray for our world. At the birth of Jesus, angels proclaimed peace to the world. We worship him now with joy, and we pray with hearts full of faith. And we say, may your birth bring peace to all. Lord, fill your holy people with whatever good they need. Let the mystery of your birth be the source of our peace. And we pray, may your birth bring peace to all. You came as chief shepherd and guardian of our lives. Let Pope Francis and all leaders of various faith traditions be faithful channels of your many gifts of grace. And we pray, may your birth bring peace to all. King from all eternity, you desire to be born within time and to experience the day-to-day life of men and women. Share your gift of unending life with us. And we pray, may your birth bring peace to all. Awaited from the beginning of the world, you came only in the fullness of time. Now reveal your presence to all of us who are expecting you. And we pray, may your birth bring peace to all. You became man and gave new life to our human condition. Now give the fullness of life to all of our brothers and sisters who have died. And we pray, may your birth bring peace to all. We pray for everyone that is here today, that all of us may experience true Christmas joy and take that joy into our lives from this day forward for the rest of the year and beyond. And we pray, may your birth bring peace to all. We pray for Brother Sean and Brother Rob. We wish them a Merry Christmas, and we also ask for that peace that surpasses all human understanding be with them this day and throughout the year. And we pray, may your birth bring peace to all. We pray for all of us in the world who may not have enough to eat, enough water to drink, or a shelter over our heads, or no one to love us. We pray for all of our people in the world, that they may have all of that, all the necessities of life, including someone to love them. And we pray, may your birth bring peace to all. And now in a moment's silence, just listen to what God has to say to you in your hearts this day, and open your hearts to receive the blessings of the Christ child. And we pray, may your birth bring peace to all. And now together let us pray the Our Father, Mother God, and bask in the glorious blessings of Christmas in the Christ child. Our Father, Mother, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come and your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who've trespassed against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, and yours is the power, and yours is the glory, now and forever. Amen. And now our concluding prayer before our blessing. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that as we are bathed in the new radiance of your incarnate word, the light of faith which illumines our minds may also share through in our deeds. We ask this through the cosmic Christ, who lives and reigns with you and lives with the Holy Spirit in unity, one God, forever and ever. Amen. May the Lord truly bless us this Christmas day, and may all of us be protected from every evil, and bring us all to that everlasting life that we attain to in this world and the next. Amen. And now for a final blessing. In the beginning, O God, was your word, a light in the darkness shining. Your word came to life in Jesus, a light in the darkness shining. Your grace has come to us with salvation, a light in the darkness shining. A child has been born among us, a light in the darkness shining. Your love comes to life within us, a light in the darkness shining. May your love trace away every evil, a light in the darkness shining. May your mercy come and fill and transform us, a light in the darkness shining. May we live with your love in this world and have your blessing upon us, a light in the darkness shining. Amen. So thank you for taking time to be here today and celebrate with your family and your friends, and have a wonderful day and a restful sleep tonight, knowing that you are truly blessed this day by the Christ child. So open up your hearts and receive these blessings. Don't close your heart and don't say that you're not enough and you're not any good and why would this happen to me and endless lies that are perpetuated in our heads. So know that you're good enough. You're created in this world that makes you good enough. So blessings of the Christ child on every single one of us today, and all the abundance and beauty that the Christ child can give us. We open our hearts for this day. And we praise and thank you, God, for everything that you do for us. So we ask that we be together again. And in the meantime, we wish you blessings and namaste.